राम नाम लक्ष्मण दो भाई, संग नारी सुकुमारी सुहाई। कौशलेश दशरथ के जाए, हम पितु वचन मानी बन आए। Very sweetly, Ramchandra ji answers Hanuman. He says, "O Brahman Devta, I am Ram, and this is my younger brother Lakshman. We are the sons of King Dasharath, and we are here following the instructions of our father. But why are you in such a state of disarray?" Ramchandra ji answered, "Iha hari nisichar vai dehi, khojat viprathi rahi man banahi." We are wandering from one forest to another, searching for my wife Sita, who has been kidnapped by a demon. Hearing these words, Hanumanji was satisfied that these two were not spies sent by Bali. So he said, "I take your leave now, O royal sages." "Ruko, stop. You have asked for our introduction, and I have given you that. And you are leaving without telling me who you are." "Kaha ho vipra nij katha bujhai, O Brahman Dev, tell us who you are." And as soon as Bhagwan Sri Ram said this, Hanuman ji said, "Maharaj, you are the Supreme Lord. I am an ignorant soul. If I ask you who you are, then it is perfectly all right for me. But you are asking me who I am your humble servant." प्रभु परिचानी परेहु गहि चरणा, सो सुख उमा जाई नहीं बरना। शंकर जी सानी पार्वती जी, हनुमान जी immediately fell at the feet of lotus feet of भगवान श्री राम, and the happiness he felt, उमा ओ पार्वती, the happiness that he felt at that time cannot be expressed in mere words. सो सुख उमा जाय नहीं बरना, it cannot be expressed in words. Now the question is, Ramchandra ji should not be asking Hanuman ji, "Who are you? He is the omniscient Lord." Hanuman ji should not be asking Ramchandra ji, "Who are you?" because he is Bhagwan Shankar himself. So what is going on? Once again, the confusions are put forth in the Ramayana because we tend to be very confused. By default, we have doubts about people in this world and about godly saints and God Himself. I must say that we do not discriminate when it comes to doubts. We will doubt anyone. We will doubt our friends, neighbors, we will doubt our teachers, we will doubt our guru, we will doubt even God, we will doubt everyone. So here Ramchandra ji is telling us in the Ramayana, by using these divine personalities, that confusions and doubts and delusions do not do good to anyone's mind, and they do not bring about any good results. Parvati ji was confused. Look what happened to her. She had to give up her body. She was not accepted by Shankar Bhagwan. Garuda ji had confusions about Bhagwan Sri Ram, and look what happened to him. He went from one to another, and he was so confused, he was in a terrible state of mind. So even Hanuman ji is expressing doubt. And then we have so many more personalities who are expressing doubts. And then we find something very unique in the Ramayana, and that is that the demons, who are supposed to be Ramchandra ji's enemies, they are understanding Ramchandra ji to be who he is. They recognize Bhagwan Sri Ram, and these are also divine associates of Bhagwan Sri Ram who have been brought with the Supreme Lord. For instance, there is Bali himself, Sugriv's brother, who has ousted Sugriv from the kingdom of Kishkindha. Bali was killed by Bhagwan Sri Ram, and Bali is laying on his deathbed, and what does he say to Bhagwan Sri Ram? He says, धर्म हेतु अवतरु गोसाई, मारेहु मोहि व्याध की नाई। My Lord, you come to this world to establish dharma, the principles of righteousness. Then how is it that you have killed me so treacherously? You have been so treacherous. You hid behind the tree and you killed me treacherously. How is it that you could do that? You are Bhagwan. You are not an ordinary man. So this indicates very clearly that Bali knows who Bhagwan Sri Ram is. That he is a saint. Bali is a pure devotee of Bhagwan Sri Ram. He is recognizing Bhagwan Sri Ram to be who Bhagwan is, to be who he is. Ramchandra ji smiles and says to Bali, would you like me to give you the gift of life? You are complaining that I have killed you treacherously. So would you like me to give you life? Would you like me to restore you to perfect life? Bali says no.
Koti koti muni yatan karahi antaram kahi avat nahi.
Countless sages and ascetics try so hard, they labor so hard for this privilege that I have today, and that is to remember you at the time of death. And you are putting an end to my life. I am beholding your divine form as I lay here dying. I am extremely fortunate, my Lord. I do not want life because no life can be better than this death. This is such a sweet death. I am fortunate to be dying at your hands. And so Bali accepted death willingly and happily at the hands of Bhagwan Sri Ram. And then there is another demon, Marich, the one who assumed the form of the golden deer. As Marich is about to set off on his mission, he is expressing the great happiness he is feeling. He is saying, I am so happy. Today I am going to have the darshan of my Prabhu Sri Ram. My eyes are going to behold the vision of Bhagwan Sri Ram. I am so fortunate. I am immensely blessed. Ravan himself recognizes who Ram is. He says, Khar dushan mosam balvanta tinahi ko marai binu bhagavanta. Ravan is saying that Ram has killed Khar and Dushan. These mighty demons, they were brothers of Ravan. Ravan is saying, my mighty brothers, Khar and Dushan, these mighty demons, they cannot be killed by anyone except for God. So if Ram has killed them, he has to be God. Ravan realizes Ram to be God himself. So the question is, why is he seeking enmity with Ram? It is simply because, well, there are two reasons for that. One is that Ravan is in the body of a demon. He is a Rakshas. And as a demon, he cannot attach his mind to Bhagwan with feelings of love and adoration. So he is attaching his mind to Bhagwan Sri Ram with feelings of adversity and with feelings of hatred. Because you see, attachment can be formed in two different ways. Through love as well as hatred. Perhaps you have heard this before, perhaps you have not, but it's very interesting to note that attachment is of two types. One is love, the other is hatred. They are like two sides of a coin. If you have a coin, one side is love and the other is hatred. The coin being attachment. So there are personalities such as Dashrath and Kaushalya and Lakshman, Bharat, Shatrughna, Mother Sita. All of these personalities have formed an intense attachment to Bhagwan Sri Ram with feelings of love and adoration. But then there is Marich, and then there is Kumbhakaran, and there is Ravan, Bali. These demons have formed an intense attachment to Bhagwan Sri Ram with feelings of hatred and enmity.